Sri Krishna Janmashtami. Everything about the Lord is divine, His birth, His acts, His names, and so on. To protect the good and to control the evil, He keeps coming to our world as necessary. He came as a fish, boar, man-lion, and of course as man. Do you recall what He was called when He came as a human lion to save Prahlada? Lord Narasimha. Sometimes the Lord appears, stays for a brief time, and disappears, as Lord Narasimha did. Other times, He stays with us for a long time, as Lord Rama did. When the Lord is with us for long, good thrives and evil shrinks. When He ends His manifestation to be visible only as a deity, evil slowly returns. Bad people think, Lord Rama ended His avataram and is gone from Ayodhya. As the deity or the indweller, He can't hurt us. We can do what we want. Then they begin harassing the weak, just as bullies become mean to other kids when the teacher's not around. When things look really bad, the Lord comes again to our world to set them straight. Evil was rising quickly in the Dwapara Yuga, thousands of years ago, and the Lord decided to come to us as Sri Krishna. Powerful kings were taking to evil ways, making people quite miserable. One such evil king was Kamsa of Mathura. He threw his own father into prison to become the king. Next, he threw his own sister Devaki and his brother Vasudeva into prison the moment he heard that their 8th children would kill him. He killed their 6 sons as soon as they were born. The Lord made sure that the 7th son got transferred to Rohini Devi, another wife of Vasudeva, who was safe at Gokulam, the village on the other side of the river Yamuna. Finally, it was time for the much-awaited birth of the 8th son. Then came the most auspicious time. It was midnight, dark but peaceful. All the good people had a nice feeling that something lucky was about to happen. The evil people had a bad feeling and felt restless. The Lord appeared in His divine, radiant, beautiful form, holding His conch and discus, but Mother Devaki asked Him to appear as a human infant. She feared that the evil Kamsa would come to kill Him. Comforting His mother, Devaki, He took on the form of an ordinary infant and asked His father, Vasudeva, to exchange Him with the baby Yogamaya, who was born as a little girl to Mother Yashoda in Gokulam. Though the Lord became a tiny little newborn, His divine powers were intact. That's why the prison doors opened up right away and none stopped Vasudeva as he stepped out to carry the infant Lord to Gokulam. All the Lords had magically fallen asleep and they were snoring. No one saw Vasudeva leave the prison because they were all snuggled inside their cozy homes while it rained hard outside in the dark. The divine snake Adisesha became an umbrella and protected our newborn Lord and Vasudeva from the pouring rain. When Vasudeva came to the river Yamuna, he was amazed to see the huge river and rapids give way for him to cross the other side safely. Vasudeva reached Gokulam. Quietly, he gently kept baby Krishna next to Mother Yashoda and took up baby Yogamaya into his arms and went back to the prison. The prison doors closed behind him. The guards woke up and quickly called Kamsa when they heard the baby's cries. Kamsa rushed down to the jail, grabbed the baby Yogamaya, but when he tried to kill her, she leapt into the sky and warmed him to be good and disappeared. The next day was a grand, happy day in Gokulam. Everyone was overjoyed and lovingly welcomed baby Krishna by celebrating his birthday. They made it a holiday and feasted and played all day. They had party games and great treats. They wore new clothes and sprinkled colors and pelted butterballs on each other for pure fun. The birds chirped, the flowers bloomed, and the sky was bright. everyone and everything was happy. Krishna was with them, promising great fun.